Okay, class. So now we are in quarter 3, week 4. Our topic for today is summarize narrative text based on elements. Our objectives, you will be able to identify the different elements of the story. Ano bang mga elements of story, ma'am? And then, we are going to summarize the narrative text, yung mga narrative story or short story using the elements of the story. Okay, you listen very well. Mag-focus kayo ha, para naman matutunan kayo today. So, syempre, we need to review what are the examples of actual text. Who can answer that question? Number one. Okay, si Andrea Denise, yes? What is your answer, number one?
Ano po, ma'am? Yung interviews.
Okay. Ano pa? Textbook. Yun lang ba? Textbook. Ano pa?
News report.
Okay. Ano pa? Alam mo pa ba? Marami ka pa bang natatandaan?
Instructions.
Mm-hmm.
Recipes.
Mm-hmm.
Record of history.
Mm-hmm.
Editorials.
Okay. Good job. Next, number two. Naglalag ako. Okay. Number two, what are the examples of literary texts?
Ma'am.
Si Hassan or Jana? Hassan.
Ano po? Hassan. Short story, poem, tapos narrative essay.
That's correct. Sige. The next is, next slide na tayo. Ayan. Dapat class, alam niyo to ha. Alam niyo yung mga examples ng factual, ng literary, kasi kasama yung sa test niyo tomorrow. Okay? I'm sure alam niyo na yan kasi nagpicture na kayo ng mga examples niyan. Kaya nga nagpa-picture ako para mas lalo niyong matandaan ang mga examples niyan. And it is also important na alam nyo ang saan kayo kukuha ng mga factual informations, yung saan kayo makakuha ng mga true informations, di ba? Alright. So now, class, we move on to our main topic. Our main topic for today is about summarizing, okay? We are going to summarize narrative text, okay? So, para matutunan mo kung paano gawin yan, you have to pay attention. Okay, let's define summarizing. Summarizing is an important skill in writing, okay? Diba, meron tayong mga different skills. Reading, ano pa? Speaking, listening, mga skills yan, and writing. Okay, yung summarizing ay isang skill to na dapat mo rin matutunan sa writing. It enables you to extract the most important points from text and rewrite them in your own words or in a shortened form. Ito lang naman ang tatandaan nyo when you are summarizing or nagsasummary ka, nagsasummarize ka ng isang text or story. Okay. S-U-M. Tandaan nyo yung S-sum. Sum, S-U-M. Shorter than the text. Mas maiksi. Siyempre, ang haba-haba nun. Kaya mo siya sinasummarize kasi ang haba-haba. Kaya mo siya isa-summarize. Papaiksiin mo siya shortened form. Pero hindi mo naman siya isa-shortened form na kung ano lang yung gusto mong isulat doon sa summary mo. Hindi naman pwede, ito gusto ko ilagay ito, ito gusto ko. Hindi ganun. Kaya natin pag-aaralan yung elements of story para lahat ng mga important details sa story ay nandun sa summary mo. Okay? Next, use your own words as much as possible. Gumamit tayo ng own words natin pag pinaparaphrase natin, ganun. Pero syempre, beginner kayo. So, minsan, hindi nyo pa alam kung paano talaga totally magparaphrase. Siguro, pili na lang kayo ng mga words na pwedeng iparaphrase. Diba? The beautiful girl is ganun. So, instead of using beautiful, pwede nyo na lang sabihin, the pretty girl is going to the market, ganun. So, hanapin nyo na lang yung synonyms niya or you can use dictionary. Yung cellphone nyo, may dictionary naman yan, di ba? And then, the main ideas or the important details lang nung story ang ilalagay. Hindi lahat kung ano lang yung gusto nyo. Kaya, i-guide kayo ng lesson na ito. Okay? Next is, we are going to read two paragraphs or two texts or narrative texts. So, who wants to read the text A? Ayan, si Irigan na. Okay na. Irigan, turn on your mic and read the text A.
Text A. Mario stood calmly by the door of the principal's office while waiting for his teacher. He looked further to check on his advisor if he would be coming because she was nowhere. After a few minutes, a spectacled man was in sight. It was the school principal. Mario told the principal about the purpose of his visit. He made his statement clear why he brought his cell phone to school. He told the principal that his classmates shouted at him in their classroom, telling him that bringing cell phone was not allowed. He felt weak explaining his reasons for doing it. He told the principal that it hurt him to have violated a school policy, but doing this made him feel secure to text or call up his sick mother at home. He told the principal that he was sorry for doing it, but it hurt him because his purpose was concern for his sick mother. The principal patted the apologetic pupil on the shoulder and spoke to him kindly.
Okay, thank you, Irigan. So you notice, class, ha? I use the Mario, I already assigned this story to you last time, di ba? I use this story para mas familiar kayo and you can connect easily, okay? Para pag nag-summarize tayo, mas maintindihan nyo how. Okay? So text B, we'll read the text B. Nice.
While waiting for his advisor to come, Mario visited the principal offices. His purpose was to explain why he had brought his cell phone to class early. His classmate noisily reminded him that bringing cell phone in school was not allowed. Nevertheless, Mario told the principal that it hurt him to violate the school policy, but he had to do it. Mario said that he felt secure to text or call his sick mother. The principal just patted the apologetic pupil and spoke to him kindly.
All right, so that's Dennis pala yun si Dennis. All right, so I have two questions here. How is text A different from text B? May pagkakaiba po ba sila? Si text A? Oh, sige. So, anong pagkakaiba nila?
Maikli po yung text B, tapos medyo mahaba po yung text A.
Okay, sabi ni Salvador, yung text A is longer and text B is shorter. Alright, so that's correct. Kasi si text A, that is the original text. Tapos si text B, that is the summary of text A. Kaya siya mas maiksi, kaya siya shortened form na siya. Okay, so next question. How are the two texts the same? Do they contain the same main idea and details? Class?
Yes.
Pareho lang ba sila? Yung bang may nabago ba? Yung main idea ba? Nandun pa rin?
Nandun pa rin po yung
main idea.
Okay. Alright. So, tama kayo. The main idea or the important ideas are still given in the summary or in the text B. Tama naman yun. Kaya nga, when you summarize a text, dapat alam mo ang five WH question and how. Dapat alam mo yung who, sino, who, what, where, when, why. Yan yung mga 5WH question. Okay? Kung hindi mo alam yan, hindi ka makakapag-summarize kasi yun yung mga important details na kailangan mong ilagay sa iyong isa-summarize. Okay? And how pa pala. Alright. Next. So, syempre, dapat alam mo yung elements of story. Since we are going to summarize a short story, dapat alam mo ang important elements or the different elements of story. We have the characters, the setting, the plot, the problem. Yung sa plot, under ng plot, problem and the solution. Tapos yung theme na yan, dapat alam mo. Ibig sabihin ng theme, pag narinig mo yan sa mga story, the moral, okay? The moral or the lesson that you could get in the story. Or what is the lesson that teaches you? Or what is the lesson that you could get in a story? Sa every story, meron kang lesson na makukuha. Ano yun? So yung sabihin mo, okay? So now, when we say characters, it answers the question, who, di ba? Who, sino? Who are the people, the animals, animals, kapag fable yung story, di ba? Or other creatures. Sa characters, meron kang major characters, and then meron kang minor characters. Major characters, yun yung mga to whom the story focuses. Sila nakafocus sa kanila yung story. Katulad ni Mario, siya yung major characters. Pag sinabing minor characters, si mother, si principal, mga minor. Ganun, ha? Okay, setting, when and where the story happens. Dapat alam mo yan. Pag nagbabasa ka ng story, yan na dapat agad ang pumapasok sa isip mo. Ah, characters to. Ah, ito setting to, when and where the story happens. Minsan, class, sa setting, di ba? Minsan, yung setting, it's not directly stated. Hindi siya agad, nakikita mo ka agad kung nasan yung setting. Minsan, you can just conclude or guess na, ah, yun pa, itong setting yan based dito sa given statement sa story, ganun. Okay? And then, sa plot naman, syempre, ang plot ay ito yung mga events, okay? The events that takes place in a story, okay? It has beginning, middle, and ending. So, kapag nagsasummarize ka, pwede mo rin sabihin sa in the beginning of your story, yung characters, yung setting, tapos in the middle, yung problem, and then the ending, yung solution. So, ganun lang yung pag-aksunod ng kwento mo. Okay? Ay, wait lang. Na-discuss ko ba yun? Problem, syempre, sa isang story, may problem lagi doon. What is the problem or the difficulty of the main character? Tapos, solution, what did they do to solve the problem? Okay? Syempre, may solution naman at the end, diba? Ganun naman ang mga story. So, in summarizing, I made this class para sa makita ninyo kung paano mo isa-summarize, diba? Minsan kasi, nahihirapan tayong mag-summarize dahil, bakit? Dahil beginner pa lang tayo, hindi pa naman talaga tayo, wala tayong idea paano mag-summarize ng isang short story, di ba? So, eto, I got this para may guide tayo how to do it easier, di ba? Mas madali, mas masaya, alright? So, una, guide mo to, someone who is the main character daw. Gamitin natin yung very familiar na kayo ng story. Si Mario, siya yung main character eh. O, dilagay mo. Mario. O, next question. Yung guide nyo yung nasa box ha, yung naka-box sa taas, yun ang guide question nyo. Para sunod-sunod nyo siyang sagutin, tapos makakabuo kayo ng summary, nung story. Next, wanted. What did the character want? Eh, ano ba kasing gusto ni Mario? Ano bang gusto ng character? O, pwede mahidugtong doon. Okay, Mario wanted to bring his cell phone to class because he felt secure to text or call his sick mother. Okay. Next ka na. Punta ka na sa next na step. But naman daw. But. What was the problem? O, didugtungan mo ng but. But, ano bang problema ni Mario? But his classmates shouted and told him that bringing of cell phone is not allowed. Okay? So, yun yung but mo. Yun ang problem dun sa narrative na binasa nyo, kung binasa nyo talaga yung binigay kong worksheet, ha? So, may so na dito. So, how did the character solve the problem? Ito na yung next guide mo. So, paano niya na-solve yung problem? Alright. So, he went to the principal's office to explain the reason why he brought his cell phone and apologized to the principal. Diba? Ganun ang ginawa niya. Then, ano nang ending ng story? Then, the principal patted the apologetic pupil and spoke to him kindly. Yan naman ang ginawa ni principal, di ba? Or, pagka, syempre class, pag ginagawa niyo to, pag meron kayong ganitong draft ang tawag niyo dito, susulat niyo muna dyan. Syempre beginner, kailangan namang alam mo kaagad kung anong isusulat mo, di ba? Syempre practice-practice ka. Dyan mo isulat yung mga sagot mo. Sundan mo yung mga guide question na yan para makabuo ka ng isang summary. Tapos, pag alam mong, if you think na ready ka na, tama na yung ginawa mo at nakuha mo na yung mga important details, saka mo siya isulat sa another paper. Tapos, gawin mo siyang paragraph form. Ganito na siya. Mario wanted to bring his cell phone to class because he felt secure to text or call his sick mother. But, ito na yung but, may problema. But his classmate shouted and told him that bringing up cell phone is not allowed. So, ito na, sinold niya yung problema niya. So he went to the principal's office to explain why he brought his cell phone and apologized to the principal. Then, ang ending, the principal patted him, 'di ba? Ganun, and spoke to him kindly. Okay, tapos na. Nakapag-summarize ka na. Okay? So, look at this. The first picture is what we already used. Okay, ginamit na natin siya. Kanina, yung somebody, sa character, wanted, what did the character want, but what was the problem, and then so, how did the character try to solve the problem, and then the end of the story. So you can use this next picture, itong nasa kabilang picture. Pag nagsasummary, when you're summarizing, pwede mong gamitin ito. In the beginning, next, then after that, at the end, guide mo rin to, your guide, okay? In the beginning, yan ba susulat mo sa in the beginning, o di sabihin mo yung character, yung setting, pwede rin. Ayan, so parang ganyan lang, halos the same, almost the same sa, dito sa somebody wanted, but so then. Somebody, oh, in the beginning, oh, di ilagay mo dito, in the beginning, ano ba ginawa? May text time babasahin. Next, then, after that. Okay, tingnan natin yung sample ko dito. Okay, this one is also familiar to you because I've already assigned this to you. Okay, let's read. Who wants to read this? Ito ang gagamitin natin. Summarize natin to. Who wants to read this short text, please?
Last year, the Girl Scout in our district celebrate their anniversary with a journey. The purpose of this trip was to explore the Virgin Fortress of Palawan, since the forests of Palawan have not yet been touched by loggers. Many of Girl Scouts who went were independent girls and did not need help in doing basic or essential things like cooking and hiking. Learning the meaning of cooperation helped them make their trip a success. By working together, well, most of them learn much and enjoy the trip. They learn the value of preserving or taking good care of our forests to avoid floods and soil erosion.
Okay, thank you so much. Salvador, okay. Salvador. Kasi wala kang camera, hindi ka nakita Salvador eh. Ba't hindi ka nakakamera? Alright, so let's summarize that text. So we could use this one. Alright, or someone wanted. Or we could use this one. Okay, so let's try to use the second picture kanina na pinakita ko. In the beginning. In the beginning, just state the characters or the setting. Okay, halimbawa, the Girl Scout in our district wanted to celebrate their anniversary with a trip to Palawan. Ayan, yan ay beginning mo. Next, anong gusto nilang gawin? Oh, the reason for this trip is to learn about the Virgin Forest of Palawan. Oh, tapos ka na. Then, kasi maiksi lang naman yung story eh, di ba? So, hindi naman lahat kasi ng story, they are short or they are too long, di ba? So, depende sa story. Eh, maiksi lang yung story na binasa natin eh. Alright? At the end of their trip, doon ka tayo sa ending na tayo. At the end of their trip, they learn the value of preserving and taking care of our forest. So, na-summarize natin siya. Andun naman yung mga important details. So, sinundan lang natin to. Okay na. Okay? So, remember class ha, a summary restates only, restate niya? The main points or the important details of a text without giving examples or details such as dates, numbers, or statistics. Okay? Do the following in writing a summary. Refer to the central and main ideas of the original text. Magbibase ka lagi sa original text. Hindi ka pwedeng magdagdag, ganon. Read the 5WH and how questions in mind. So, dapat alam mo yung elements of story. Alam mo na kaagad kung ano yung mga kailangan mong ilagay doon, yung mga 5WH question. Who? Sino? What? Ano? Ano pa? When? Kailan? Where? Saan? Why? Bakit? And then how? Paano? O yun. Dapat nasa mind mo yun habang. Dapat ang comprehension mo pag nagbabasa ka mataas. And then, paano kung hindi? Ganon. Siyempre, magpa-practice ka. Read and read and read. Magbasa ka na magbasa. Mag-practice ka magbasa. And then, later on, magiging madedevelop yung comprehension mo, okay? Yung reading skills mo, right? Next, keep your summary brief, okay? Brief means, maiksi lang, pero nandun lahat na important details. And then, use your own words. Siyempre, pag beginner ka, hindi ka naman ganun pa ka-expert. So, pwede man namang yung mga important details na i-add mo. And then, kung kaya mong palitan yung mga words ng synonyms nila, yung same meaning nila, edi better, okay? And later on, perfect mo rin yan. Okay? So, I have here a short story of the travelers. Ako na magbabasa ha para mas maintindihan ninyo. And then we're gonna answer the some questions and then we're going to summarize the story. So, you better listen para mamaya may maisagot ka naman pag nagtanong ako, okay? At ma-summarize natin yung story. Okay, the travelers, two good friends, Lino and Nardo, were traveling along a narrow, dusty road toward the city. Okay, they are traveling. They have been traveling on foot from morning up to noontime when they decided to rest under a big mango tree by the roadside. Okay, so they are so tired, exhausted, they wanted to rest under the mango tree. While they lay their weary heads on their knapsacks, okay, pahinga na sila, okay, they saw something half buried in the dusty road just in front of them. May nakita sila naka half buried. Ano kaya yun? Lino got up, tumayo si Lino, ano to, to get the buried thing. See what I found? It's a heavy bag, he said. Sabi ni Lino, see what I found? It's a heavy bag. Why say I found? Sabi ni Nardo, bakit I found? Ikasama kita eh, bakit? Why not we found? Eh, magkasama tayo, di ba? Sabi ni Nardo. Lino shook his head. Sabi niya, no, it's mine alone. I found this. I, sabi niya, ako lang. Eh, nandun kakasama kayo, di ba? Selfish rin to si Lino, yun. He said aloud as he opened the bag. It contains clothes and some money, he added. Ay, hindi pala yun. Hindi pala narrator yun. Dialogue niya pala yun. It contains clothes and some money. Sabi, masayang masaya siya. Added joyfully. After they have rested a little, tapos na sila magpahinga. They continued on their way. Lakad ulit sila. Neither one was talking. Walang gusto magsalita sa kanila. Tahimik sila pareho. Lino patiently carried the heavy bag. Eh, si Lino ang nakapita kaya siguro siya yung magbuhat-buhat. Suddenly, they heard heavy thuds from behind. Yung heavy thuds, alam niyo, yung dumadagundong, yung step-step ng horse or ng baka, ng cow, yung naririnig na lupa, ganun, dumadagundong. They look back and saw, tumingin sila, ano ba yun? They look back and saw four men on horseback. They seem to be looking for something. May nahanap sila, ano kaya yun? Baka yung bag. They rode so fast that they caught up with Lino and Nardo in no time at all. Nahuli, nakita nila silang dalawa, yung two friends. Sabing ganun nung king's horseman. Tiff! You, Tiff! Sabi niyang ganun. One of the men said, pointing to Lino. Eh, si Lino may hawak ng bag eh. Kaya siguro, Tiff! You, Tiff! Sabi niya, alam niya may Tiff, di ba? Magnanakaw, ganun. How dare you steal the king's bag? Sabi niya, steal the king's bag. He continued shouting. And then, sir, no, sir! Lino said with trembling voice. Alam niyo, takot na takot si Lino, nanginginig sa takot. Sir, no, sir, we found this bag on the road. You can have it, sir. Ganun siya. Sobrang takot niya. Siyempre, may espada yun, di ba? May sword yun, makasaktan sila. Sabi niya, we found this bag on the road. Oh, ngayon, we found na. Kanina, I found, ah. Okay. The king's horseman, seeing Lino's sincerity, got the bag and proceeded to the city. Okay, so binigay na ni Lino yung bag, di ba? And then, umalis na yung king's horseman. When they were gone, nung nakaalis na, sabi ni Nardo sa kanya, nag-emo si Nardo. Sabi niya, when you were in trouble, you did not hesitate to say we found, did you? Sabi niya, nung nakita mo yung bag, you're so happy, at I found, ikaw lang nakakita. Pero nung nagka-problema na tayo, hindi ka na nag-hesitate na sabihin mong, we found, dinamay mo pa ako, sabi niya. That's the end of the story. So now, syempre, we are going to summarize it using the important details, okay? The essential details. But before that, let's answer some questions para malaman natin na naintindihan nyo yung binasa ko and ma-summarize natin siya kasi naalala nyo yung mga important details, okay? So, Lino and Nardo were blank. Ano sila? They were? Wala, walang nakatanda. They were enemies? Ano sila?
Hello?
The main characters, ma'am.
Oo nga, they are the main characters and they are
friends
what in the...
Mom.
They are friends. Yes, correct, Denise. They were friends. Okay, next, weary from traveling because they were exhausted. They decided to... What did they do? Because they were so exhausted. Tired. Sleep. Okay. They rest under a
mango tree.
Mango tree. All right. And then along the dusty road, they saw a half buried thing. What is it? They saw something. Okay. A bag. Okay. A half buried bag. Okay. Then the thing or the bag is full of what?
Clothes and money.
Money.
Okay. That's correct. Clothes and money. And then see what I found. See what I found. Who said that? Who exclaimed that?
Lino.
Soon they were apprehended by or they were stopped by sinong nag-ano sa kanila? Sino nakahuli sa kanila?
Horseman.
Okay, the king's horsemen. Okay, the four king's horsemen. Okay. And then they were accused of ano?
Thief.
All of stealing. Okay, stealing the tama, stealing the thing or the bag. Okay, Lino with trembling voice. Ano sabi ni Lino nung nahuli na sila? Ano sabi niya dun sa King's Horsemen?
Sinabi niya po na nakita po nilang dalawa ni Nardo.
Okay, tama. Sabi niya, "We found this bag." Sabi niya, "We found." Sila ng dalawa ha, "We found this bag." Next is ano next?
Binigay niya na po yung ano kay Mama.
Okay, the selection tells you what? What is the lesson in this story? Sa bandang ending, anong natutunan nyo? Or what is the moral of the story? That the story tells you that? Ano? What?
Don't be selfish.
Ano pa? Hindi ko makita yung mga sagot.
Nakikitang gamit.
Okay, sige. What else? Okay, so...
Don't tell your friends when you're in trouble po.
Don't, oh tama si Irigan. Ano yun, di ko lang napakinggan. Narinig ko yung trouble. Don't blank your friends in trouble. Ganun ba yun? Oo, tama kayong galing. Okay, so you learn that or this story tells you that, ano, some people keep their good luck to themselves and, ano, share their troubles to others. Ganun ba kayo? May kilala kayong ganun? All right. So now we can summarize the story. O sige, summarize na natin using this guide map or guide ano question. Sige, or all right, let's start. Someone, who is the main character?
Lino and Nardo.
Lino and Nardo. Yes, that's correct. So yan ang ilalagay mo dito sa first box mo. And then pag napuno mo na tong first box mo, saka mo na siya i-rewrite uli sa clean paper, di ba? O, lagay mo dyan, who is the main character? O, pwede nyo itong i-picturean class para makapag-summarize kayo sa next, ano natin, next time. Okay, who is the main character? Lino and Nardo, what they wanted? What did they do? What did the character want when they were tired? Ano ginawa nila? They are?
They sleep in the mango tree.
Okay, they rest weary from traveling or because they are exhausted, they decided to rest under a mango tree. O, sige, yun ang gusto nilang gawin. But, what was the problem? Anong naging problema? Ano na yung bat nyo? But, they saw a, ano?
They saw a bag.
Okay. They saw the king's bag. O, pwedeng ganon. And then, anong nangyari? May dumating na...
Four horsemen.
Okay. The king's horsemen apprehended them and accusing them, anong ina-accuse sa kanila?
Stealing the bag.
Oh, yun ang problema. That is the problem. Oh, na-state mo na yung problem mo. So, punta ka na ngayon sa next na box. So, how did the character solve the problem? Anong ginawa ng character?
Give back the bag.
Oh, sige, give back. Ni-return niya na yung bag. Alright, so na-solve na. Sabi niya, we found this bag, I don't steal this. Eh, wala pala siyang sinabi, I don't steal. Okay, Lino returned the bag to the king's horseman. O, di umalis na yung king's horseman. Nag-explain pa siya, he explained himself na he just found the bag. Diba? Then, anong ending? Anong sinabi sa kanya ng friend niya? Then, anong sinabi ng friend niya sa kanya?
Well, winag niya po siya.
Okay, sabi niya ito, balikan natin.
Hindi siya nag-hesitate na gumamit ng we pag nasa, ano po siya, gulo.
Tama, galing ni Irigan. Okay, Nardo said, When you were in trouble, you did not hesitate to say, we found, did you? Okay, and that's the end of the story. Okay, so ganun lang siya mag-summarize. Siyempre, it takes a lot of practice kasi siyempre, pag beginner ka, hindi naman agad alam mo na agad yung susulat mo. Pero, it will definitely help you kapag alam mo yung mga elements of story. Kaya wag na huwag niyong kakalimutan yung set character, setting, yung plot, yung problem, yung solution, yung ending, yung moral of the story, ganun ha. Okay? So, dahil magpapatest ako tomorrow, so hindi muna ako magbigay sa inyo ng activity about this topic, okay? Para naman, hindi tayo, makapagpasa kayo on time, okay class? So, you study, you review the previous lesson natin, yung unang lesson natin. Then, mag-test kayo within the day, ha? Alright, so that's all for today, class. Have a good day. So, bye-bye, class.
Thank you,
bye-bye. 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 Bye-bye.